Mr. Taru, in this example lesson, we're going to be taking a look at a problem that involves implicit differentiation, using the product rule a couple of times, finding the derivative at a point, and then finding the equation of the normal line. In the description, you'll find a link to other lessons I have done involving implicit differentiation, and this question is inspired but not exactly like a previous IB exam question that was worth 7 points. Five for finding the derivative at a point, and two for finding the equation of the tangent line. So let's get started. Okay, so we are going to be taking a derivative as indicated by this notation with respect to x. So we're going to take the derivative of the left and right hand side implicitly because we got all these x's and y's mixed up. And we have dy dx is equal to, now we have the product of two functions here, and we have the product of two functions that are inside the tangent function. So a little bit of nice practice for our process of taking a derivative. It's going to be the first times the derivative of the second. So we have x, the derivative of tangent is of course secant squared of pi x y over 8, and then we have to take the derivative of the inside function. And I'm going to go ahead and leave the first, or think of that first function as pi over 8x, as opposed to factoring out the constant or coefficient, if you will, of pi over 8. So we have the first function, which is pi over 8x, times the derivative of the second function. And we are taking a derivative with respect to x. So I'm going to do a dy dx. I'll write it as y prime in the next line, plus the second function, which is y, times the derivative of the first function, which is the derivative of pi 8th x, or pi x over 8, is equal to pi over 8. And then it is going to cancel away, but finishing up that chain rule like you saw me do here with the dy dx, we're going to have a dx, the derivative with respect, derivative of x with respect to x. I'm just really, in case needed, showing how we end up with a y prime, but not an extra x prime, because, well, the derivative of x with respect to x just sort of, by notation-wise, cancels out. Okay, so what did we just finish there? The first function times the derivative of the second. So x times the derivative, all of this is just the derivative of tangent, pi xy over 8, and then plus, now, on this outside function, the second function times the derivative of the first. So dx over dx times the tangent of pi xy over 8, which, of course, this again is going to cancel. Okay, so what we're looking at basically is y prime is equal to x secant squared of pi xy over 8 times pi over 8xy prime plus pi over 8y plus the tangent of pi xy over 8. Now, we can, you know, if I was asked to find the derivative of, like, y prime, like solve for, you know, find dy dx or y prime, then we would take this expression, we would distribute it through the parentheses and do some algebraic manipulation until we have y primed, that notation by itself. Here we're not asked to find dy dx, we're asked to find the derivative at a point. So I'm going to save myself some algebraic work and simplify this problem by going, hey, I just need a numerical value, an instantaneous rate of change of this function or curve at the point 1, 2. So why do all the simplification for solving y prime with all the algebra when I could just be doing more like arithmetic with the numbers? So at the point of 1, 2, we have y prime is equal to, well, x is going to be 1, so then we have secant squared of pi times 1 times 2 over 8 times pi over 8 times 1, y prime, plus pi over 8 y, which is 2, plus the tangent of pi times x, which is 1, times y, which is 2, over 8. Okay, so we have y prime is equal to the, just to show all of this. So simplified, we have y prime is equal to secant squared of pi over 4 times pi over 8 y prime plus pi over 4 plus tangent of pi over 4. So now let's work out our unit circle. We have y prime secant squared of pi over 4. Well, the secant of pi over 4 is, of course, 1 over cosine. That's going to give us square root of 2 squared times, again, just showing all this work, times pi over 8 y prime plus pi over 4 plus, and then the tangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1. Well, the square root of 2 squared is 2. Distributing that value of 2 through the parentheses is going to give us y prime is equal to 2 over 8 is 1 fourth y prime plus pi over 2 plus 1. Let's move the terms that have the y prime together, and we have 1 minus pi over 4. I'm going to go ahead and think of just subtracting it over to the left-hand side and factoring out a y prime is equal to pi over 2 plus 1. Finding a common denominator, we have 4 minus pi over 4. Y prime is equal to pi plus 2 over 2, multiplying both sides by the reciprocal to find y prime, and we have y prime is equal to pi plus 2 over 2 times 4 over 4 minus pi. Of course, that's going to reduce nicely, giving us y prime or dy dx at the point of 1, 2 is equal to 2 pi plus 4 over 4 minus pi. Okay, so now we have the derivative of this curve at the point 1, 2 as 2 pi plus 4 over 4 minus pi. So hopefully helped you out a little bit with your understanding of implicit differentiation and the product rule. Now we're going to find the equation of the line normal to this curve at the point 1, 2. Okay, not the equation of the tangent line, but the equation of the normal line. Of course, hopefully remember that your tangent line is basically parallel to a curve at that point C, giving you the instantaneous rate of change, and a normal line is perpendicular. So we just need to write the equation of a line, just like in algebra 1, a point, we have that, in a perpendicular slope. Well, of course we know perpendicular slopes are opposite reciprocals, so we're going to flip this equation and, you know, introduce that opposite idea, pull out a factor of negative 1 or multiply it in. So the equation of a normal line is y minus 2 is equal to m times x minus 1. Let's make sure I did not make any errors here. Matches my notes. Excellent. IB is happy with equations of tangent lines and normal lines in point-slope form. If you're in an IB class, excuse me, an AP class, they're going to want those equations in slope-intercept form. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.